get working. Hello, all you are, of course. Out there, not members area. How you doing? 7:45 in the morning. I've got Kent, the hardcore's hardcore. Got Asda, got Kent, the hardcore's hardcore coming on at 8:30. Taking Pokemobile for oil change and a rear spring on back. I had Outlaw Inc card in last week. My ex mother in law. I picked her up, she gets in back, doesn't she, Outlaw? I thought, what was that then? Driving, I thought, I'm sure something doesn't seem right when I was driving anyway. When I took Outlaw out, you put two fingers, don't you, on top of the wheel. And if you can't get your two fingers there on between from tyres to arch, you've got a spring problem, haven't you? Anyway, sure enough, she done my spring. It was probably on its way anyway, but about 18 clems sitting on it. I'll soon finish it off, won't it? So that's that. Get your money out, Russell. Done about 6,000 since oil change, so we'll have that done. But other than that, I'm alright. Right, I watched the Boxing Asylum this morning. Been in office early. I thought it was quite funny actually. Tickle me them lads, don't they? And I watched the Eddie Hearn interview. I only watched one. He's done a boxing social one and another one. And it looks like he's under pressure, doesn't he? Eddie was being interviewed by Umar, IFL Umar. And look like, you know what it is with Eddie? He's had it all his own way that much. He's controlled everything. He's not in control now because the balance of power's tipped towards Bricktop, hasn't it? Do you know what I mean? 147.7. Fucking robbing bastards. 145 in Edlow. So what am I coming here for? I'm a man of principle. Probably because can't be arsed. Petrol. Do you remember when Boris said it'll be a quid? Eh? Eh? Said it was going to be a quid, didn't he, Boris? Eh, well, they were wrong, weren't they? Eh? Fucking liar.
I can't.
to see Eddie squirming, well, it's like reading Playboy magazine for me, isn't it? Hey? So, I just think that Eddie should be a little bit more humble now that he's on back foot, because he's on back foot, innit? We know that, don't we? He's on back foot. Look at that, 147.7, you wankers. Eddie's on back foot and he should be more humble. But he's not going to be, is he? He's going to be having to dig about questions. And I do agree with him to a certain extent, though, but I think Umar's the one that pushes it more than anybody. Rob Tebbutt tries to make them too complicated, and half these people who Rob Tebbutt's interviewing don't understand his questions anyway, because he's too well educated, isn't he? But Umar, to be fair, does ask probing questions, but he doesn't have Frank Warren, does he? He's hanging out of the back of him. But that's just boxing, isn't it, at the moment, isn't it? It's Eddie's controlled the narrative for 10 years. And he's at a stage now where he needs IFL, doesn't he? Because boxing will move on from Eddie Hearn. Don't you worry about that, it'll move on. Proper. It'll move on. But it's going to be interesting to see, isn't it? So you're alright. Should have pulled up and give a Terry Chapandama's number. Get him off Tinder. I think he's saying Terry's been on Tinder. I don't know. How many of you people that are watching, members area, want to come on a Zoom? How many? How many of you daren't? Just curious. Just curious, how many of you dare? No, to be frightened of. A lot of people on social media, they have plenty to say, don't they, in comment section. Plenty to say in emails. Plenty of. See what I get sent. Woo-hoo! When I don't get sent anything, though, that's when it's time to worry, innit? But how many of them, though, I'd really love to come out? I don't know. Right, I've got a question here for you all. Members only can enter this. I'm going to give a present. I'm not going to say what it is. I'm going to send it to somebody. It's an ornament that you can have in your house. Not cheap either. I'm not going to say what it is, but I'm going to do a question here. This is a question for you. Alright. Who was the first boxer to be a three-time world heavyweight champion of the world? The first one. See if you can get that one. That's an easy one, that, isn't it? Let me know and I'll post you this. It probably cost me intending to post this. It's that big. But okie dokie. You know what I've noticed? What was this here? Oh. Do you know what I've noticed there? I've noticed people are buying electric cars a lot. Townie pulls up here, puts his plug out of the car through a window into his office underneath mine. I'm wondering if that's the way forward, electric cars. It's going to be interesting, isn't it? Moving forward. I don't know if that's going to be the right thing. My old man, he's on about getting an electric one. Kev's got an electric one. He's got a brand new Discovery, but he only gets about 40 mile out of it, electric. And you've got to charge it, haven't you? But I'm on about full on electric. Do you know what I mean? Full on. My kid's mum keeps going on about the new RAV4 electric. I said, well, good fucking luck with that then. Ta-ta, phone down. But I'm just wondering if that's the way forward, but I don't know. But Eddie Hearn looks to me like he's struggling a little bit with his position at the moment, because he's really hot back, funny. Frank's got everybody into position at every weight. DeBar, Joyce, Fury. They're all in position now, aren't they, for the takeover. And we could be looking at a bricktop reign. Is that a good thing? Yeah, it keeps it in Britain, doesn't it? It's if Tyson Fury keeps fighting, isn't it? If he don't, well, you're going to have problems, aren't you? Do you know what I mean? But it's going to be interesting moving forward. I just wonder what everybody's thoughts were and Eddie's attitude at the moment. Am I glad he's on back foot? Fucking too right I am. It's wanking tackle for me, isn't it, that? So I don't like him. I don't like what he stands for. He's never overcome adversity in his fucking life. Mr. Relentless, do me a fucking favour.